What's going on, guys? Jkun Prime here with another Marvel Avengers video. So we have gotten a game overview of how this game is going to play out, which is going to give us some more visuals. It's going to give us an idea of how the story is going to progress and how we're going to be able to play the game, not only in solo, but along with our friends as well. But before we dive into this, if you could leave a like rating on the video, I would greatly appreciate it, as it shows your support and it lets me know what kind of content you like to watch on the channel. So let's get down to business, check out this video, and see what's in store for us.
Marvel's Avengers is a third-person action-adventure game featuring an all-new, original story where you play as your favorite Avengers.
I see they've cleaned up Thor.
At the opening celebration of the Avengers West Coast headquarters in the reveal of the team's new Terrigen Crystal Reactor. But after being blamed for a disastrous explosion that leaves San Francisco in ruins, the Avengers are forced to disband due to public backlash and government pressure.
Damn.
In their absence, a new organization rises vowing to protect the world, Advanced Idea Mechanics, otherwise known as AIM.
AIM took over Avengers Tower? Holy shit.
The world is a very different place. In their pursuit of a safer future through science, AIM has replaced superhumans with their advanced synthoid AI.
Ladies and gentlemen, we just found our disposable enemy for the game.
A conspiracy against heroes begins to unfold. With all superheroes outlawed, an Avengers fangirl from New Jersey named Kamala Khan embarks on a quest to prove her hero's innocence and become who she was destined to be. Kamala plays an essential role as the catalyst to reassemble the team with her unique perspective and incredible powers. Only together can the Avengers overcome the dangers in this new world.
So she's basically going to be the main character of the game.
In a decommissioned helicarrier, which gets upgraded throughout the story. You can customize your heroes to play solo or assemble online with your friends, defending Earth from ever-escalating threats. Each of the heroes
has tons of weapons,
inspired by over 80 years of Marvel history, as well as original new ones. As you play, you'll earn and unlock gear. Equip different gear pieces to customize your playstyle and become even more powerful. Power up gear by unlocking perks, which will change the way you play the game.
All right, so this is where the RPG builds are going to start coming into play.
Build your heroes to fit your playstyle. Using the war table, you can launch into two different types of missions. Hero missions are the single-player campaign experiences showcasing specific heroes. And Warzone missions, which are played solo or online, with up to a total of four players. All missions drive the narrative forward, and all of your heroes' progress is shared across the entire game. Reassemble the Avengers and rebuild the team. Heroes
once that was great. Her just, bah! And she sends a guy into orbit. Okay, so I really liked what I saw right there. So everything is going to progress the narrative of the story, which is cool. There are going to be missions that you can do on your own, which, cool. Miss Marvel is basically going to be the main protagonist of this game. That's perfectly fine. I have no problem with Miss Marvel. Plus, you're going to get situations where I'm sure you're going to be playing the other characters as well. And then you're going to have the Warzone missions where you can play whoever the hell you want. So that doesn't bother me in the slightest. The character builds start showing that RPG element where play the character your way. Build him up how you want to build him up. So if you want Iron Man to focus solely on ballistic weaponry, you can do that. Or if you just want him to focus on mobility and repulsor weaponry, you can totally do that. And that is good. That is something that I really feel like this game needs. And I've heard many, many rumors about this game possibly being games as a service, something very akin to Destiny. Now, you guys that watch my Twitch channel know I am a big fan of Destiny. So if this is going to be games as a service and it's going to play like Destiny, I say bring it on, because you are doing two things that are very near and dear to my heart. A game with infinitely replayable content and superheroes. Now, if they could ever just do this with Green Lantern, I'd be on easy street here. But hey, I'll take what I can get. But let me know what you think about Marvel's Avengers down in the comments below. Are you even more excited for this game like I am? Or are you just kind of like, whatever. Another superhero game. Waiting for Batman Arkham 7. I don't know. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. I'm very excited for this, and the fact that we can now pre-order and get beta access, I'm very much looking forward to this, and I think it's going to be multi-platform as well. It's going to be on Xbox, it's going to be on PS4, and I think it's also going to be on PC, and if it's going to be on PC, that may be the route I go, but we'll wait and see what happens. There's always been the old saying, play where your friends are, so I may have to wait and see who's getting this on what. A lot of my friends still play on console, where I've been slowly making the shift over to PC gaming. But thank you everyone for watching. Hit that like button if you could. Definitely would appreciate it. Subscribe if you're new. And why don't you check out my Twitch channel as well. Twitch.tv/JkunPrime, where I stream damn near every day of the week. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you later.